making a watercolor.
A still life.
It's a still
life. So right now we're just sketching the beautiful
Right there, life. that's when Ty knocked the water over. With her mile-long elbows. Also dangerous when tickling her.
Don't tickle Ty! Yeah. She'll spike you.
So the girls got... The girls got the travel koi watercolor kits for their birthdays this year. And we...
I have the better one. I have metallics.
That's true. You have metallics.
I have more colors.
Ty has more colors. Yeah. I got to use the...
We're even.
I got to use the cheap watercolors. And it just goes to show that whatever you have, you can make art, right? So what are we doing now? Oh, we brought out the chalk markers and did a little bit of details.
Why is it just filming
it? Because you put in a background, kiddo. So there's your background. All right, let's take a look at Samantha's masterpiece.
They're looking at a sunset. And
amazing.
The hello girl's like, yes, we can look at the sunset.
Yeah.
And they're going to do an art project.
Clearly, because there's scissors right there.
Because there's scissors and crayons.
And a crayon right there. Yep.
And there's flowers, because they need the flowers.
There's a cup on the blue monkey's head, because Ty put it there.
Yeah. I decided he needed a hat.
Okay. This one's mommy's.
Yeah, that's mommy's.
Yep.
It's so detailed, it almost just looks like if we move the still light.
Sort of, sure. I'm pretty happy with it.
And then Ty's, the cartoonist.
I like that it's different views of the same thing. That we got kind of a 180 degrees of monkey happening. Woo! I love your colors.
I didn't do this
one. I like the rose.
I like the faces on his arm.
I did the fade.
That's it. So here's the other one. This one was just me. So this is the pirate monkey that I made for Tyler. I made a lot of sock monkeys. I started when I was pregnant with Tyler. I started making sock monkeys because when I was 9 months pregnant, I couldn't move. I couldn't do things that involve standing, which was usually what I do. So I started making monkeys because I wanted to make something special to photograph her with as she grew. One of those, you know, you put a stuffed animal next to the baby, and every month you put the same stuffed animal next to the baby, and you see the size comparison as the baby grows. So I made a bunch of monkeys for Ty, and we picked one to be her special monkey and took a picture with it. This was not the special monkey. This one was a little later, and I started getting braver, and I made some pirate monkeys and some, gargoyle monkeys. You guys can talk. So I did this one by myself so that we could do a close-up because we still haven't quite figured out cameras yet. But first it was the blocking out the basic shapes. So there was a circle for the head and an oval for the nose and ovals for the ears and then kind of a rectangle for the body and then those long kind of hot dog shapes for the arms and legs. And so first you do the basic big blobs, and then once you have that, you do the pencils, and then you come through with the inks, and then you start to paint.
And make sure you go in the lines, like only in the lines. That's really hard.
Yeah.
Hard.
Yeah, I think the main thing to remember is to choose a waterproof ink if you're going to do watercolors, or even if you're going to do markers or something. Choose a waterproof ink for your lining and wait for it to actually dry before you start painting, or even before you start erasing so you don't smudge it. And then when you're doing watercolors, you want to make sure if you want nice clean edges that you let things dry in between the edges. So the red needs to be dry before I paint the black next to it, or it'll just bleed into it. The watercolor will just go wherever the water is. Once it's dry, you can layer it and you can paint on top of it. You can tell that I usually use acrylics and not watercolors. Like that. That's how it flows into itself. You can tell I usually use acrylics because I keep trying to dab at it with my finger, which works really well for acrylics. I can always blend with my finger, but with the watercolors, it kind of just makes like that dark patch in the middle of my fingerprint. It's a delight. But you know, learning is good. That's what guilds are for. So you can learn new things. So here we are painting in the shadows.
That looks so good after. You should wait until the end.
Well, I mean, hopefully they'll wait until the end because the end's pretty close. But yeah, it's
this video is really short.
There's lots and lots of shading. It's one thing that I always try to do is a lot of shading because I think it helps make things look more realistic. But you have to be careful with watercolors because they stain the paper and then you're kind of stuck with your color and you can't really get highlights with watercolors unless you're using the paper color for your whites. So a lot of times people will go in with a gel pen, which is what this is. This is a gel pen to do some highlights and some stitching for the sock and for the parts. So when I make sock monkeys, I always make the faces with felt because it's so easy to cut into shapes and stitch on. I tried the kind of traditional way at first and it never had the personality that I wanted it to have. So now I always use felt, and he's got a little felt tattoo of an anchor, and he's got a little felt smile with stitches to delineate the teeth. And a little felt hat, my very first ever pirate hat. Turned out okay.
Yes, it's so good.
You like it? You're so sweet, thank you. And yeah, there he is. Tyler's sock monkey pirate. He's one of my favorites of the monkeys. Maybe someday we'll do monkey video. And that's it.
Thank you for watching.
If you'd like to join the guild, check out our Patreon for more fun stuff.
It's so fun!